Let us understand how fertilization takes place in a bisexual flower. So here this is a pistil or a carpel, where this is the stigma, this is the style, and this is the ovary part. Now the pollen grains have arrived on the stigma. The pollen grains have a nucleus in them, and they are known as the male nuclei. Now, one of the almost all the pollen grains would be originating a pollen tube. However, all of the pollen tubes would not be able to travel through. One or two pollen grains might have that significant energy to produce a pollen tube which is able to transfer itself through the style. Now the style can be hollow, so the pollen tube can come along quickly. Sometimes the style can be solid. If it is solid, then the pollen tube has to release certain digestive enzymes known as lysozymes, which would dissolve the cells on the path it is coming through and make its path feasible through the style. Then this pollen tube would tend to transfer the male nucleus to the ovary part. Ovary has this ovule. There are three cells on the upper side known as antipodal cells, three cells on the lower side, out of which the middle one is known as egg cell or female gamete. These two cells are known as synergids. These are the nurse cells which protect the egg cell till the male gametes do not enter. The male nucleus divides into two nuclei known as male gametes. This point is known as micropyle, micropyle. Micropyle transfers the male gametes to the ovule. Now the male nucleus has divided into two male gametes. Now there is an egg cell which is protected by the synergids, and there are two secondary nuclei in the center. One of the male gamete would fuse with the egg cell or the female gamete to form the zygote. The second male gamete would fuse with the secondary nuclei to form the primary endosperm nucleus. Now the zygote is the future plant, and the primary endosperm nucleus would divide and redivide to form the endosperm. So zygote would further get converted into the plantlet, but endosperm would give its food and nourishment till the seed germinates. So the ultimate fate is that stigma and style would wither off, ovary would get converted into fruit, ovule would get converted into seed, and the zygote would develop into the future plant. This entire process is known as double fertilization, in which one male gamete combines with the egg cell to form the zygote, second male gamete combines with the secondary nuclei to form the primary endosperm nucleus. This together is known as double fertilization.